Good morning, guys. Welcome back to another episode of Bearham Engines. So, first of all, you're not going to be too happy with me. I've managed to sneak out for an hour or two to crack on with the M3 build, and it's a Sunday. Now, I know what you're going to say, should be at home spending time with the family. Now, bear in mind, I don't think I've done any overtime for as long as I can remember. But you can all see from my last video how busy we are in the workshop. So I have literally got no time to spend on this M3 engine of ours for the E30 at all. I've always maintained that it's very easy when you've got your own business to want to do your own stuff because you're your own boss, you can do whatever you want, but I've always maintained I'm not going to do that. So if it means that I have to sneak out for a couple of hours, I've just snuck down here, guys, and what I'm going to do is, well, I'm facing the valves at the minute, so I've cleaned all these valves up, just giving them an extra clean now, laying them all out. I showed you the other day, the cylinder head is all looking spangly. So what I'm going to do is I've just tried an inlet valve in the inlet ports and in the inlet guides, and the same with the exhausts. And the exhausts are a little bit sloppier than I'd like, really. If we try that down in that guide, like, you can see a tiny bit of back and forth movement. There's probably about a mil or so of movement there on the head, so not good enough. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sleeve those guides in a moment. Now, I've measured the stem, they're 6 mil. So we're going to head over to the K-line kit over there. And we're going to bore these out and put some K-line bronze guide liners in there and size them to suit. Like I've said to you before, I don't want these a real snug fit. You know, these are a pretty revvy motor anyway, so we want a little bit of play. But if we have a look what's in the inlet, inlets don't tend to wear anything like exhausts as a rule, but there's probably 5 or 10 thou of play in there. Well, that is exactly what we want, really, with this engine. We don't want enough that the valve's going to start moving side to side when it goes up and down and create lack of compression, or it's knocked itself off the seat. And we certainly don't want enough wear in that guide that oil's going to pass through it under vacuum and it starts smoking on the overrun. So we don't want that. So we just want enough play that it's not going to bind up the guide. You've got to be a bit careful with bronze, steel to bronze, because it can bind up. So we certainly don't want that. But we just want enough play in there so we know it's running safe. So just finish cleaning these valves, guys, and we'll head over there. So first thing we've done is we've found a tool. Obviously, you've got 30 on one side if it's a 30 degree seat and a 45 on the other. So we found one that sits on the 45 of the existing seat nicely. So that's that one there. We've got the 6 mil K-line guides here, the guide sleeves, and we've got the 6 mil kit. So it comes with various size balls. This is the tool that you push the guide through. This is the initial reamer. So this, what it does is you've got the 6 mil guide on the front, followed by the correct size cutter on the back. So that just follows the existing guide, and that gives you the correct interference to push those guide liners in. Here we have various toppers to top the guide liner either side, for the amount it protrudes, and that basically top it down to the top of the existing guide. So, got our kit, guys, let's crack on. So first thing we do is we get our drill, we get our boring tool with the holder for the seat steady on it. We pop that on there and we put this in the drill. Tighten that up. And we put it in the first one here. And what I normally do is if you level that seat guide there, pop the air on, check that that slides up absolutely free, and then we just air off, and that one is nicely bored out. So now we're using our driver tool here. So this is an air jack that drives this spring-loaded tool here, and what that does is it air jacks one of the guideliners in. So we pop that in. You've got a leading edge on one of these guideliners, so you've got a tapered edge and a square edge. Square edge goes in the tool, sits back there, and then we just drive this in. And what I do is pop my finger underneath, holding it on the bottom of the guide, and you can feel when the other end comes through. And you want to be going through just enough to get that leading edge through. A lot of the time the tool just gets stuck in there. Pull that out. You can see where those guideliners just stick out underneath there. That's what you want. Now what we're going to do, guys, is we're just going to top off the backs first. You see there, I haven't done those, and they're protruding slightly, and these ones I've just topped off. So we'll just go through these quickly. Go, then we turn over the cylinder head, and I just top off the tops here. So the next step, guys, is to find the correct ball. And we pop in the 6mm tool to push the ball in. Right. Now, to find the correct ball, what we do is we get an exhaust valve over here. And sorry for everyone who's a bit more modern than me. I normally work in Imperial on this. So, because the balls are in Imperial, actually. So the stem here is 0.234, so that's 234 thou. So we have a little look, see what size balls we've got. We want to be going about 2 thou bigger to start with. So we've got 240, so that's 6 thou bigger. So we certainly don't want that. We've got 237, which is 3 thou bigger. We could probably get away with that, actually. That's probably what we're going to end up using. And 238. So 237 is the smallest one we've got here. And to be honest with you, that is probably going to give us a tiny little bit of movement on the guide. I'm going to drop that. That's 60 quid each, these little balls are, and that's all they are. What we do, we get a pair of tweezers. The ball in the tweezers and just drop it on the end of the guide there. Then we want to drive it through, ensuring that we put our hands the other side and catch the ball so it doesn't disappear. There we go, caught it. Take our deburring tool. Okay, put that down the guide and just turn it a little bit. That just takes any burr off the top, and then we try our valve in there. And to be honest with you, that is absolutely perfect. We've probably got about 2 or 3 thou of play in there, which is what we want. We don't want it any sloppier than that, and we certainly don't want it any tighter. So that is perfect. So we're going to stick this ball down all of them. Sometimes if it's a little bit too snug, we don't go the next size ball, we run the same ball down twice, and that usually solves the problem. But if it's a little bit tight in there, then usually you have to go the next ball up. Right, guys, before we go back over to the cylinder head, which is over there, we've just headed back over to the block. Now, Next stage on the block, before we can put the head on, obviously, we're going to put the pistons in. We've done our dummy build before we stripped it down. Obviously, we're going to be using the same pistons. We have removed 5 thou off the top of this block, okay? So what I'm going to do, we're using a standard thickness gasket. So what I've done here, you see, I've put this piston in with the rings. I've removed 8 thou off the top of this piston. So you can see these four edges, that is the top. So what that area, or what these areas are here, are the squish areas between the piston and the cylinder head. So I've just took about 3 thou extra to what we've took off the block. Obviously, we've took a little bit off the cylinder head. So I've took 3 thou off that, and that just gives us a little bit extra room between the piston and the cylinder head, just to be on the safe side, because we are going to be using this, obviously, for the tracks mainly. So just a little bit more leeway there. Now, next step, obviously, to get that off, what we are to do is we've got to remove the pistons off the rods. So we've got number two off here. We'll keep number two off. Although we've took the material off there, 8 thou, which we're doing on the mill, we're leaving this one behind till last. And the reason for that is we've got to nick the pin out of this, the gudgeon pin. Now, with number three, we've took number three off the rod, and I'll show you why we're using the gudgeon pin. So what we do is we turn this over and we put the pin in there until it sort of comes flush with the inside. You see that there? Now we head over to the mill, and you see the other pin is here out of number two. So we're going to put that pin in the other side there, and we push that one up flush as well. So now we've got both pins up there. So what we do, guys, we set the clamps on those pins either side. Now we only need to clamp them very lightly just to hold the piston down. So before any of you say, oh, I wouldn't be doing that, distort the piston, it won't. We are literally just nipping it down. Now, we've got to ensure with the mill, we've got an 8 thou cut on here already. So we've just got to ensure that this side, that the studding and the nut all sits lower than the face. Otherwise, we're going to start topping the stud off with the cutter. Just do a little check, make sure it's not moving. And then we rapid the cutter over. Making sure that that cutter is right at the edge of the piston. Then we just press the go button, and that's putting an 8 thou cut on that piston now. And then we're going to go on to size the rings. We're using a set of Hepalite standard size rings here. Now, I did say to you, we're reusing the old pistons. The pistons are mint. The ring lands are perfect. This engine is actually done under 80,000 miles from new, which is unusual for a E36 M3. They're usually all done over 100. But the pistons are mint, so we're going to use re-rings. We're going to re-ring it. Now, I know what many of you guys are going to say. Well, if you're re-ringing your own engine, why don't you re-ring customers? It's all to do with the warranty side of it, to be honest with you. As an engine reconditioners, we cannot re-ring anymore. Just in case something happens. We're obviously willing to take that risk on our own engine. If there was any doubt whatsoever with this, and it's the same on some customers' engines, we've measured bores that are perfect, the pistons are perfect, but unfortunately we have to bore customers' engines and put new pistons in. So it's just literally a cost thing with our engine here. We know that the chances are, there is a slight chance that obviously the rings are not going to bed in, like I've said to you before, but it's highly unlikely, but unfortunately we just can't do it on customers' engines. So the rings, we have to now gap the rings. Now you can see I've got a top ring in this cylinder, I've got a middle ring in this cylinder. Now, first of all, we've got the packet that it all comes out of. On the other side, it tells you which groove, which ring goes in, but we know that because we've got a chromium ring which goes in the top, the cast iron ring goes in the middle, and then we've got the oil control rings here. Now, first of all, we've checked the oil control ring gap, but usually they're way, way bigger than what they need to be. So we've got about a 25 thou gap in the top here. So if I go over to the ring gap specifications, we've got an 86.5 mil bore here. So it says between 75 and 89, which is the one we want. The oil ring gap needs to be, so 0.25 is 10 thou to 1 millimetre. So that's the range that you can run. And we've got about a 25 thou gap here. So it's about sort of in the middle of that, probably a little bit less than in the middle, but that's absolutely fine. Now the second ring, you've got 0.25, which is 10 thou, to 0.5, which is 20 thou, and the same on the top ring. So between 10 and 20 thou, we have measured these gaps, and we have got about a 16 thou gap. So it's right in the middle, absolutely cock on. Not going to interfere with that. Even if you was running it on the lower side, it would probably be all right. We'd probably open it up a bit, but 16 thou is bang on, really. I've noticed when I've gap rings before, some people have said in the comments, well, why don't you gap them all in the same bore? Because, guys, these bores measure all the same. We have put each ring in each bore and the gap's the same. So the only reason I've put it in different bores is just to show you, for example purposes, really. But yeah, we check them in every bore. So I'm really happy with the ring gaps. So the next thing is get these rings onto the pistons once I've took them off. And the same as number one here, let's get them down the bores. And that is the pistons and rods in. Obviously the crank, we are not going to be able to get in until we've balanced it, but we can't balance it until we get our clutch and flywheel back, which are due back this week sometime. So hopefully by the end of next week, we can have the crank back, the crank balanced in the block, and the short motor built up with the head on, etc. So yeah, going to be cracking on. By this time next week, this engine's going to be well on the way, guys. The sandwich plates on here that hold the buckets in, I've just got to get the bolts and tighten this down. We'll torque that down. Just showing you example here. You see down there, look, the valves are in, stem seals and the spring bases are all in. The stem seals just hold the valves in, make it a lot easier for us to do the clearances. So what we're going to do is we're going to get them bolts in, torque this down, get the cams in, and we're just going to check the clearances. At the moment, I don't know what the clearances are. I'm going to have to go and have a look on the auto data just to confirm what they are. And we can check these. If in doubt, like I've said in the last video, we should just, if they're a bit tight, we'll just take a little bit off the face of the stem here. If they're a little bit loose, we can take some more off the 45 degree seat the other end and bring the valves back through. But my feeling is these ain't going to be far out. So there we go for another video, guys. Purely informative today, I'm afraid. No dramas. Go over to our second channel and check the video tomorrow. Cheers, guys. Have a great evening.